University of Rochester's Solar Energy Graduate Program gives students the tools necessary to not only study solar energy technology, but to become entrepreneurs and leaders in the field. While they earn their doctorate in engineering or science, students are taught the business and politics of alternative energy.
Very often scientists and engineers are very good people technically and scientifically, but they are fairly ignorant of the economic and business questions as well as the public policy questions. What we want is we want them to become not just players, but in fact entrepreneurs in the field.
My research involves looking at the interaction of silver nanoparticles and light and how that might be used to enhance the scattering of the light into silicon solar cells. It's important because the price of solar cells is obviously a big hindrance to adopting photovoltaic technology and hopefully shifting away from a more fossil fuel-based energy economy.
We will have two international components to our program. The first one will bring our students to European laboratories where they will learn and practice the technology that's being developed. The second internship is going to be in Africa, in one of three African countries we have selected. And they will go there to do field work as well as to help teach courses in African universities. In quite a few countries in a developed world, we have a situation where the cost of electricity is extremely high, which makes some of those renewable technologies immediately affordable, immediately possible. We would like some of our students, as a result of their studies, to actually go in this field and develop solutions that can be used to improve the quality of life of people in those countries. We have focused this program on energy available from the sun because the sun is the largest possible source of energy. However, today, the technological solutions that have been implemented are not really good enough. They are either too expensive or the technology degrades over time. So there is an enormous potential on the one hand and a very big technological need on the other hand. So this is why we thought this was going to be what we would call a low-hanging fruit. Our new program is extremely multidisciplinary and will produce students who are not traditional students. Those students, of course, will be firmly grounded in the science and technology behind their discoveries, but they will also have acquired a wealth of knowledge that the traditional science and engineering students do not have. So in a sense, this could be a template, could be a model for other multidisciplinary initiatives that will eventually change the nature of higher education, especially at the graduate level.
This is the University of Rochester.